Hi folks, Luis Caseto here. In this video, I will cover the installation process of the modeler in the macOS. I'm using a virtual machine with a fresh macOS installation. The version is the 15 Sequoia. Okay, then let's go and open the Salesforce documentation about the installation process. Here I will open the prerequisites, and the first step is to install the Visual Studio. Let's go. VS Code download. Okay, here I will download for macOS. Allow. Okay. Okay, the Visual Studio code is here. I will move the app to application and I will open the Visual Studio code. Okay, here we are with the Visual Studio code, and now we can move to the next step. The next step is to install the Git. For it, we will use the Git bundle with macOS. Then let's open the terminal. Okay, I will fix it in the dock. Okay, and now we will type xcode-select install. Okay, enter, and here open the pop-up to confirm the installation, agree with the license, and wait the installation. Okay, installation was completed. We can move forward and test if the Git was installed properly. Let's type Git version. Okay, the Git is here. Okay, now the next step is the Node.js. For that, I will use the NVM, Node Version Management. And this is a great tool. You can easily install the Node.js. And also, it's possible to have more than one Node version on the same machine. Let's open the NVM site. NVM install. Node version manager, GitHub, and here we have the script to install the NVM. But first, we need to check if the profile file exists in the home folder. For that, let's add s no file that doesn't exist. I will use the command touch to create the file. Okay, now we can move forward and install the NVM. To do that, let's copy the script and paste in the terminal. Okay, the installation was completed, and here we have an information. We need to close and reopen the terminal. Let's do that. Close, reopen. Okay. And now we can test the NVM. Okay, NVM was installed. And now we can install the Node.js. For that, I will use the command nvm install and the version. In this case, the version is the 2020. Okay. Okay, node installed. Let's check node version. Okay. Installation was completed and we can move for the next step. And the next step is to install the Salesforce CLI. Okay, let's copy the command. And paste. Okay, and here to test the plugin, we can run SF plugins. Okay, no plugins installed, but we need to check the node version of the SFDX. For that, we will use the command SF. Version. Oh, sorry. SF version. Okay. And here is the SF CLI node version 20. Great. Now we can move to the next step. Okay, Python, we need to install the Python 3.11. To do that, I will use the Homebrew. Homebrew is a package manager for macOS and Linux. This tool will help us to install the correct version of the Python because we can't use the latest Python version. We need to use the specific version 3.11. Let's go. Let's open the Homebrew website, brew, okay. Okay, nice. Let's copy the script, come back to the terminal and paste. We need to provide the password. Okay, and now we need to run these commands. Let's copy and paste. Okay, great. And we need to restart the terminal. Okay. And now we can install the Python at 3.11. Okay, let's wait to install the Python. Okay, now the installation was finished and it is necessary to add the Python to path environment variable. To do that, we will open this link with more information and we will use this command. Let's copy. Okay, and now we need to edit this file. And put the Python to the export path variable. Now we need to paste. Oh, and we need to fill the Python version. Okay, now it's good. Save the file. And again, close and reopen the terminal. Let's check the Python version. Great! We have the right version of Python. Okay, let's go to the next step. Python is okay, now the browser. We need to download the Google Chrome. Okay. Let's go to google/chrome. Download the Chrome. And install the Chrome here. Okay. And here you have the Google Chrome. Let's open. Open. No. Start. Okay. Google Chrome was installed. Next step. Well, I think you already have the Salesforce org with customer goods. I will not cover this step in this video. We can move to the next step. And now we can install the modeler plugin. I will copy this command. And paste. Okay, plugin was installed. Let's check the version of plugins. SF plugins. And now we have the plugin installed into the SF DX CLI. And to check the modeler installation, we can run this command. Copy the command and put the terminal. Oh, sorry, without the run. Okay. Here we are with the modeler installed properly.